senses and the admiration of a world of people. As man, a species born and who's lived all his life on Earth, moves with this journey out into the solar system, and so, presumably, begins with this journey his dispersal in other places out in the universe.
I had 30 minutes standing by myself on the launch tower, almost near the top, not quite to the spacecraft, but there wasn't another human being close at sight, and I could see the waves coming in, the sun slowly rising, and see the evidence, the parked cars of all the people out watching our launch 3, 5, 10 miles away, just millions of people. And it was quite a symbolic moment that I said to my hey, Buzz, you better remember this one.
It was, by definition, the greatest story of the century. I was at the press site. There were at least 1,000 people there. Probably 500 of them were duly accredited, and the rest of them were hangers-on. Little old ladies, unclassified weirdos of one sort or another. A governor of one of our states and a rock star were there, hand in hand, watching it.
There was a great sense of goodwill. There's not a whole lot of objectivity there. There was nobody there to criticize. They didn't want to criticize. They wanted to praise. They wanted to support. They wanted America to succeed. And so all the naysayers were true believers, and they wanted to be true believers.
And so, here at Cape Kennedy, we're all off to the moon this morning.
We're now 14 minutes, 30 seconds and counting. This is Kennedy Launch Control.
A civil rights march, a mule train representing the poor and dispossessed, had made its way to the gates of Cape Kennedy to protest at the nation's priorities. NASA officials came out to meet them.
We walked across this this field, which seemed to me to be a plain of battle, and the mule trains and the participants were coming toward us. And it seemed to be so out of character with all the technology that was around us.
The American government at that time had spent $24 billion on the exploration of outer space. $24 billion. Now, for the last 3 years, they had spent $3 billion. $3 billion would have fed every hungry person in America.
We're now coming up on a 10-minute mark, 10 minutes away from our planned liftoff. Mark, T-minus 10 minutes and counting, T-minus 10. We're aiming for our planned liftoff at 32 minutes past the hour. This is Kennedy Launch Control.
If one tried to say how many pieces could go wrong, it's infinite, whether it be on the ground or in a bird, and how many could cause catastrophe? A tremendous number.
Okay, Jules, we're getting close.
This is Apollo Saturn Launch Control. We passed the 6-minute mark in our countdown for Apollo 11. Now 5 minutes, 52 seconds and counting. Launch Director Rocco Patrone now gives the go. We're 5 minutes, 20 seconds and counting.
You go into your final replenishment cycle, make sure you get the amount of fuel on board. You then start pressurizing, you start going through steps leading right up to the moment of commitment, what I refer to as the moment of truth.
The vehicle starting to pressurize as far as the propellant tanks are concerned, and all is still go. Computer supervises hundreds of events occurring over these last few minutes. 2 minutes, 10 seconds, and counting. Oxidizer tanks in the second and third stages now have pressurized.
We had all these umbilical arms. We had like 10 different umbilical arms that weighed tons each. They were all linked to it.
The swing arm now coming back as our countdown continues. Skip Chauvin informing the astronauts that the swing arm now coming back.
And then all of a sudden, when all the arms were back, you realized that they were sitting there by themselves. The next closest person was at least 5 miles away, and they were sitting on millions of gallons of propellant.
Neil Armstrong reported back when he received the good wishes. Thank you very much. We know it will be a good flight.
I mean, there's no turning back once that rocket lifted off. And this was the moment, and it was getting very close to getting down to T-minus zero.
All the second stage tanks now pressurized. 35 seconds and counting. We are still go with Apollo 11. 30 seconds and counting. Astronauts report it feels good. T-minus 25 seconds. 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running.
Most people base their thoughts of what a launch is like on what they see in the movies. The transition from being on the ground to actually in motion was so gentle that none of us really, other than hearing the count go to zero and someone saying liftoff, and we could see the instruments begin to change, that would start to change at liftoff. Other than that, there wasn't a great physical sensation at all.
Roughly 300 or so feet beneath it. And the vibration then hits the control center and the windows start to shake. And great feeling, but also the apprehension is there. Yes, we had reached the moment that really the world had waited for.
There is really nothing to say about it. What can you say about a sight like that?
We got a roll program. Neil Armstrong reporting their roll and pitch program, which puts Apollo 11 on a proper heading. Downrange 1 mile, altitude 3-4 miles now.
Balance got low. Greater than
1,000 feet high, 80 feet per second vertical rise.
And a minute or so after that unbelievable event, the astronauts are talking to the ground and reporting on the facts and figures of the flight. And somebody here a minute ago was saying they are as matter of fact and unexcited and calm as if they were taxicab drivers reporting in and saying we're on Maple Street headed for downtown.
11 Houston, you are a go at 4 minutes.
With the spacecraft safely on its way, control of the flight passed from the launch team to mission control in Houston, Texas. For the next 8 days, the control room would run the mission in three teams.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Trajectory and guidance look good, and the stage is good. Over.
Apollo 11, Roger.
35,000 feet per second. Cut off.
Flight director of the White Team. I guess you're about the only person around that doesn't have TV coverage of the scene.
That's all right, I don't mind a bit.
They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the window.
Flag up now, you can see the stars and stripes.
Are you getting a TV picture now, Houston?
Neil, yes, we are getting a TV picture. You're in our field with you now.
That's one small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.